فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
What is the best definition for kufr? The best definition for kufr is anything that goes against asul iman. Kufr is anything that is in direct opposition to asul iman. The person becomes a kafir from it. We already took what asul iman means, right? Sah? We're now going to divide the kufr, insha'Allah ta'ala, in many different types. The first type of categorization of kufr in the Sharia is that the first categorization is when the Sharia uses kufr unrestrictedly. We hear in the Quran Allah used the word kufr. We hear the Prophet use the word kufr. We see it be used. Okay? The usage of kufr here, what is meant by it? The ulama, they divide it into two. It can either be, al-kufr here is what? Kufr akbar. يَخْرُجُ صَاحِبُهُ عَنْ مِلَّةِ الْإِسْلَامِ. Then the person will leave the fold of Islam. Kufr akbar. There are verses in the Quran that has come in that usage. Which is what? Surah Al-Baqarah, ayah 254. Sorry, 253. Allah says, ولكن اختلفوا فمنهم من آمن ومنهم من كفر. ولكن اختلفوا, they differed. فمنهم من آمن, from amongst them are those who believe. ومنهم من كفر, and from them there are those who disbelieve. So the kufr here is not minor. It's the major kufr. Also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says in Surah Al-Ma'idah, Allah says in ayah 17, and he also says in ayah 72, Allah says, لَقَدْ كَفَرَ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا إِنَّ اللَّهَ هُوَ الْمَسِيحُ بْنُ مَرْيَمُ. لَقَدْ كَفَرَ الَّذِينَ, they are kuffar, the ones who say عِيسَى بْنُ مَرْيَمُ is Allah. Are you with me? This kufr here is what? Akbar. Very good. Also, the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ that shows kufr akbar is the hadith Imam Muslim narrated in his Sahih, min hadith Anas ibn Malik radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, that the Prophet said, إِنَّ الْكَافِرَ, there are kafir, إِذَا عَمِلَ حَسَنَ, if a kafir does a good deed, أُطْعِبَ بِهَا طُعْمَةً مِنَ الدُّنْيَا, he's going to be provided for in this world. Bill Gates comes, he goes to the kids in Africa, he gives them charity, and he gives his wealth, he gives millions, he opens an orphan. Allah is going to provide for him in this world. In this world, Allah is not unjust. Allah is going to increase his wealth for him, maybe. Give him children, get him a better job. He'll be provided for in this world. Allah doesn't oppress. He'll give him a life in this world. وَأَمَّا الْمُؤْمِنُ, as for the believer, when he does righteous actions, فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ يَدَّخِرُ لَهُ حَسَنَاتِ فِي الْآخِرَةِ, Allah will withhold for him that good deed. Sometimes he might get something in the dunya, he may not get it in the dunya. So you might see a Muslim who's struggling, who prays salah in the masjid 5 times a day, fasting, everything, and he can't have children. And you see your neighbor, Robert, who's got, he's got 10, 15 kids. Generally, Roberts don't have that much kids anyways. Yeah. Sah? But you see, he's got a lot of kids. You're like, Ajib, this Muslim brother has been married for the last 20, 15 years. He's been trying to have kids, he can't have it. And this kafir has got kids. We'll say that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he withholds righteous deeds for the believers. Yes. And so the day of judgment, it will be given to them. Sometimes Allah gives it to them in this world. So the kufr here that the Prophet is using this hadith is what? It's the kufr akbar. That the person is not part of Islam and they're not a believer. Also, the second usage of kufr is a minor kufr, which is al-kufr al-asghar. صح? Kufr al-Asghar. And the Kufr al-Asghar is like qawluhu ta'ala, the statement of Allah, وَمَنْ لَمْ يَحْكُمْ بِمَا أَزَلَ اللَّهُ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْكَافِرُونَ. The kafirun here is minor kufr. It's not the major kufr. Abdullah ibn Abbas said that. He said, هِيَ بِهِ كُفْرٌ وَلَيْسَ كُفْرًا بِاللَّهِ وَمَلَائِكَتِهِ وَكُتُبِهِ وَرُسُلِهِ. He said, this kufr here is kufr, but it's not disbelief of Allah and the angels and the book and the messenger. Meaning those are kufr akbar. He also said, Ibn Abbas, لَيْسَ بِالْكُفْرِ الَّذِي يَذْهَبُونَ إِلَيْهِ. This is not the kufr that the Khawarij are running around with. Yeah? All of Ibn Abbas's students agree that this ayah doesn't show kufr akbar. Like Tawus ibn Kaysan, who's one of the prominent students of Ibn Abbas, he said, لَيْسَ بِكُفْرٍ يَنْقُلُ عَنِ الْمِلَّةِ. This is not a kufr that the person will leave the religion. The ayah, وَمَنْ لَمْ يَحْكُمْ بِمَا أَنْزَلَ اللَّهُ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْكَافِرُونَ. So this ayah is kufr akbar. This ayah, فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْكَافِرُونَ. We have the Turjuman al-Quran, the great Mufassir of the Quran, Ibn Abbas, saying this. We have a student, Tawus ibn Kaysan, saying the same. We also even have Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah ta'ala elaborated on this point. He said, Ibn Taymiyyah said, وَقَالَ ابْنَ عَبَّاسٍ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى عَنْهُمَا وَغَيْرُ وَاحِدٍ مِنَ السَّلَفِ. Ibn Abbas said, and more than one of the Salaf. So Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah knows Ibn Abbas more than you. He said, Ibn Abbas said this. And not only him, more than him said this. في قوله تعالى إن استيمن of الله ومن لم يحكم بما أنزل الله فأولئك هم الكافرون فأولئك هم الظالمون فأولئك هم الفاسقون. Ibn Taymiyyah said, كفر دون كفر وظلم دون ظلم وفسق دون فسق. It is a kufr besides the major kufr. It's before the major kufr. And it is a ظلم which is before the major ظلم. And it is a فسق before the major فسق. Before it. وقد ذكر ذلك أحمد والبخاري وغيرهما. أحمد said this and Bukhari said this. Ibn Taymiyyah said it. And Ibn Taymiyyah said this in his The Sharh of Hadith of Jibreel. It's a book that's published by itself. He said it in page 402. So this ayah, وَمَنْ لَمْ يَحْكُمْ بِمَا أَنْزَلَ اللَّهُ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْكَافِرُونَ. What does it fall under, major or minor? وَمَنْ لَمْ يَحْكُمْ بِمَا أَنْزَلَ. The ayah. The ayah is minor. This is the ayah is minor. Also, from the times that kufr is used is the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ, where he said, "Uritu nara," the hellfire was shown to me. فَإِذَا أَكْثَرُ أَهْلِهَا النِّسَاءُ. And I saw that the majority of the inhabitants of the hellfire were women. So the Prophet ﷺ said, I saw the hellfire. When I saw the hellfire, I saw that the majority of people in the hellfire were women. قِيلَ. The Prophet then said, أَيَكْفُرْنَ بِالْآيِهِ. The Prophet ﷺ said, يَكْفُرْنَ. They come with kufr. And the Sahabas, they said, أَيَكْفُرْنَ بِاللَّهِ. Do they disbelieve in Allah? The Prophet then said, no, يَكْفُرْنَ الْعَشِيرَةِ. They show disbelief to their husbands. وَيَكْفُرْنَ الْإِحْسَانَ. The good that the husband does, they are what? They do kufr of it. لَوْ أَحْسَنْتَ إِلَىٰ إِحْدَاهُنَّ. If you are good towards any one of them, you're good to your wife for 10 years in the marriage. You see, أَدَارَ ثُمَّ رَأَتْ مِنْكَ. And then she sees from you شَيْئًا something. قَالَ. She says, مَا رَأَيْتُ مِنْكَ خَيْرًا قَطْ. I have never, ever seen any good in you. The day we got married till today, all I've seen with you is evil. Yeah? However much that husband does, every hard work, one day he flops the show. He does not manage to take her to the restaurant that he promised is going to take her. Yeah? She says, you were never there for us. You always abandoned us. If you look at the terms that they use are always what? Very general. They leave nothing out. You're always evil. You've never been there for us. Those are the terms that are used. Huh? That's why the Prophet then said, عليه الصلاة والسلام, يَكْفُرْنَ الْإِحْسَانَ. She won't leave some. She won't say, you've let us down today. If she did, she's good. You've wronged me today. Or this week you haven't been helping us. Huh? That's good. That's leaving some. They take yeah. They take the longest yard on the discussion. Never ever. Ibn Abdul Barr rahimahullah, he says, so this hadith, what's the fiqh that we take from it? The main important point is The Prophet said yakfurna. He used the word unrestrictedly, yakfurna. They do it kufr. They do what? They do kufr, he said. So what was the Prophet referring to kufr here? Disbelief? Now he's talking about minor kufr. Minor kufr. Dangerous. Ibn Abd al-Barr rahimahullah, he said, فَأُطْلِقَ عَلَيْهِمْ نَسْمَ الْكُفْرِ لِكُفْرِهِنَّ الْعَشِيرَةَ وَالْإِحْسَانِ وَقَدْ سُمِّيَ كَافِرُ النِّعْمَةِ كَافِرًا. He says that the term kufr was used for the women because they show kufr towards their spouse and the good that he has done. So they conceal it. They hide his good. وَقَدْ يُسَمَّ كَافِرُ النِّعْمَةِ كَافِرًا. And the one whoever blessing is shown to him, he's been blessed. He's been what? He's been blessed with a blessing. And he doesn't show gratitude towards that blessing, he's called a kafir. The Quran uses kafir for one who is kufr ni'mah. Does that make sense? Allah used that in the Quran. لَقَدْ كَانَ لِسَبَعٍ فِي مَسْكَنِهِمْ آيَةٍ جَنَّتَانِ عَنْ يَمِينٍ وَشِمَالٍ كُلُوا مِنْ رِزْقِ رَبِّكُمْ وَاشْكُرُوا لَهُ بلدة طيبة ورب غفور فأعرضوا فأرسلنا عليهم سيل العارم وبدلناهم بجنتين ذواتي أكل الخمط وأثل وشيء من سدر قليل ذلك جزيناهم بما كفروا. صح؟ كفروا هي means what? كفر النعمة. Their kufr here was because the blessing that they were given. So إطلاق الكفر. So when you find the word كفر in the Quran or the Sunnah unrestrictedly used like that, كفر, it could be أصغر, it could be أكبر, it could be any one of them. So it needs to be observed. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used it like that, and so did the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Allah used it like that, and the Prophet did. Look what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says: "Sibab al-Muslim fusuq wa qitaluhu kufr." Insulting a Muslim is what? Fusuq, fisq, is transgression and exceeding your limits. Are you with me, brothers and sisters? Are we together? Wa qitaluhu, and killing a Muslim is what? Kufr. Killing a Muslim, the Prophet said, is kufr. In another place, the Prophet said, لَا تَرْجِعُ بَعْدِي كُفَارًا يَضْرِبُ بَعْضَكُمْ رِقَابَ بَعْضٍ. Do not become kufar after me, where you slice and you kill each other. Kufar. And we know that killing a Muslim is a major sin, but not kufr. Is it kufr? Killing a Muslim is a major sin, but is it kufr? It's not kufr. How do we know it's not kufr? Allah says in the Quran, وَإِن طَائِفَتَانِ مِنَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ اقْتَتَلُوا. If two parties of the believers kill one another, Allah is referring to them as believers. They're fighting one another, they're killing each other, but both parties are being referred to here as what? Believers. You all know the ayah, Allah says, يَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الْقِصَاصُ فِي الْقَتْلَى الْحُرُّ بِالْحُرِّ وَالْعَبْدُ بِالْعَبْدِ وَالْأُنْثَى بِالْأُنْثَى فَمَنْ عُفِيَ لَهُ مِنْ أَخِيهِ. Anyone who forgives his brother, he killed a family member of yours. He just killed a family member of yours. Allah says to you, whoever forgives their brother, why is he called your brother? He's a Muslim still. He just killed a family member of yours. He's still referred to as your brother. Forgiving your brother. So what do you take from this? That's the word that the Prophet meant here, وَقِتَالُهُ كُفْرٌ, it doesn't mean major. What does it mean? Minor. It means minor. ولذلك ابن رجب رحمه الله إن كتاب جامع العلوم والحكم يقول قد ورد إطلاق الكفر على بعض المحرمات وإطلاق النفاق أيضا. ابن رجب said that the term kufr has been unrestrictedly used in some places and it was referred to as what? Things that are haram. And he said that the word nifaq, hypocrisy, was used and it was referring to sometimes as what? Things that are also haram. So not every time you see the Quran and the Sunnah talk about hypocrisy, you think automatically it's the major one where the person is actually not a believer. Sah? No, it's not the case. There are other terms in the Sharia that have been used in place of kufr. The Sharia has actually used other terms that actually take the place of kufr. They mean the same as kufr. The first one is a shirk. Shirk is used as kufr. Like for example, The story of the Sahib al-Jannatayn, the story of the man of the two gardens. وَأُحِطَ بِثَمَرِهِ فَأَصْبَحَ يُقَلِّبُ كَفَّيْهِ عَلَى مَا أَفَقَ فِيهَا وَهِيَ خَاوِيَةٌ عَلَى عُرُوشِهَا وَيَقُولُ يَا لَيْتَنِي لَمْ أُشْرِكْ بِرَبِّي أَحَدًا. Here shirk is kufr. Are you there, brothers? Shirk is to associate partners with Allah. If a person takes a mushaf and he throws it in the bin, is he a kafir? We just took that's kufr akbar. Is he a mushrik? No. Mushrik is a part of kufr. Sahih? But sometimes it will be used interchangeably. Does that make sense? Sometimes you may see that it's being used interchangeably. This man here, what he did is kufr, not shirk. Are you with me? Because what did he say? وَدَخَلَ جَنَّتَهُ هُوَ ظَالِمٌ لِنَفْسِهِ قَالَ مَا أَظُنُّ أَن تَبِيدَ هَذِي أَبَدًا وَمَا أَظُنُّ السَّاعَةَ قَائِمَةٌ وَلَئِن رُدِدْتُ إِلَى رَبِّي لَأَجِدَنَّ خَيْرًا مِنْهَا مُلْتَهَدًا. صح؟ He was arrogant and takabbur and what not. This is what his action was. And to show you that the shirkiyah means kufr is that the response that the other person gave to him. أَكَفَرْتَ بِالَّذِي خَلَقَكَ مِنْ تُرَابٍ ثُمَّ مِنْ نُطْفَةٍ ثُمَّ سَوَّاكَ رَجُلًا. أَكَفَرْتَ, he asked him a question, صح؟ Very good. Also the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ is evidence where the Prophet said, بَيْنَ الرَّجُلِ وَبَيْنَ الشِّرْكِ وَالْكُفْرِ تَرْكُ صَلَاةٍ. The distance between a person, kufr and shirk, is the leaving and abandoning of the prayer. And Imam Muslim narrated this in the hadith of Jabir. Are you there, brothers? So look, kufr and shirk is on one side together, they're mentioned together, and your iman is on the other side. But you know leaving the prayer is not shirk. Is it shirk? It's not shirk. The second term that's also used with kufr sometimes, and it means the same as it sometimes, is dhulm. Dhulm. Are you there? An example for that is وَيَوْمَ يَعَضُّ الظَّالِمُ عَلَى يَدَيْهِ يَقُولُ يَا لَيْتَنِي اتَّخَذْتُ مَعَ الرَّسُولِ سَبِيلًا. The dhulm here is the kafir here. As the Shaykh Islam ibn Taymiyyah says, وَلَا رَيْبَ أَنَّ هَذَا يَتَنَاوَلُ الْكَافِرِ الَّذِي لَمْ يُؤْمِنْ بِالرَّسُولِ وَسَبَبُ نُزُولِ الْآيَةِ كَانَ فِي ذَلِكَ فَإِنَّ الظُّلْمَ الْمُطْلَقَ يَتَنَاوَلُ ذَلِكَ وَيَتَنَاوَلُ مَا هُوَ دُونَهُ بِحَسَبِهِ. Ibn Taymiyyah says that this verse, وَيَوْمَ يَعَضُّ الظَّالِمُ, it encompasses, the zalim here means that the one that didn't follow the Prophet at all. He will bite his fingers, why did I not follow the Prophet? And it also encompasses, and also falls under the verse is the believer who didn't fully follow the Prophet as well. Who followed the Prophet partially. He'll also bite his fingers the day of judgment out of regret, and he will say, why did I not follow the Prophet and why did I not make him my role model? Ibn Taymiyyah says, وَلَا رَيْبَ, there is no doubt, أَنَّ هَذَا يَتَنَاوَلُ الْكَافِرَ, that this verse encompasses, and it means also al-kafir, the disbeliever, الَّذِي لَمْ يُؤْمِن بِالرَّسُولِ, that didn't believe in the Prophet at all. وَسَبَبُ نُزُولِ الْآيَةِ كَانَ فِي ذَلِكَ, and also the ayah actually came down on the kuffar. فَإِنَّ الظُّلْمَ الْمُطْلَقَ, because the unrestricted dhulm, it can encompass, it can either mean the major or it can either mean the minor. Also Allah says in the ayah, نَحْنُ أَعْلَمُ بِمَا يَسْتَمِعُونَ إِذْ يَسْتَمِعُونَ إِلَيْكَ وَإِذْ هُمْ نَجْوَ إِذْ يَقُولُ الظَّالِمُونَ. The ظَالِمُونَ here are what? The ظَالِمُونَ here are kufr, kuffar. Because this came down on who? It came down on the kuffar of Quraysh. Also sometimes the kufr is used as a minor. And it's not major. Which is what? ثم أورثنا الكتاب الذين اصطفينا من عبادنا فمنهم ظالم لنفسه ومنهم مقتصد ومنهم سابق بالخيرات بإذن الله. This one is not meant by a disbeliever. In Surah Fatir, Ayah 32. This is a minor one. ثم أورثنا الكتاب الذين اصطفينا من عبادنا فمنهم ظالم لنفسه. They're all going to go into Jannah. Because Allah mentions جنات يدخلونها. Jannah which they will all enter. So the ظلم here is minor. So it's used as minor and it's used as major. The other term that's sometimes used is fisq. Fasiq and fisq. It's meant by the major and sometimes it's meant by the minor. Allah says, وَإِذْ قُلْنَا لِلْمَلَائِكَةِ اسْجُدُوا لِآدَمَ فسجدوا إلا إبليس كان من الجن ففسق عن أمر ربه. ففسق عن أمر ربه. إبليس is a فاسق. فسق here means what? As الإمام المروزي رحمه الله المروزي sorry said محمد نصر المروزي وكان ذلك الفسق منه كفرا. This فسق here is كفر. إبن جزء إبليس كتاب تعظيم قدر الصلاة. As for the fisq, sometimes can be used for what? The believers. And you know the ayah, وَالَّذِينَ يَرْمُونَ الْمُحْسَنَاتِ. Those who accuse those women who are sincere. A man who goes and says, this woman, she committed zina unjustly. ثُمَّ لَمْ يَأْتُوا بِأَرْبَعَةِ شُهَدَاءِ. He doesn't come with four witnesses. فَجِلِدُوهُمْ 80 جَلْدَةِ. Whip them 80 lashes. وَلَا تَقْبَلُوا لَهُمْ شَهَادَةَ الْأَبَدًا. Don't ever accept their testimony. وَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْفَاسِقُونَ. And they are what? They are فاسقون. The فاسق here means what? Yeah? فاسق here means minor. It's talking about believers who did this. Also Allah says in Surah Al-Baqarah, فَمَنْ فَرَضَ الْحَجَّ فَمَنْ فَرَضَ فِيهِنَّ الْحَجَّ فَلَا رَفَتَ وَلَا فُسُوقَ وَلَا جِدَالَ فِي الْحَجَّ. فُسُوق here means minor, not the major. So these terms are used as a minor, and they also used as what? Minor and major. So we've understood that. What's the difference between al-kufr and shirk? What's the difference between al-kufr and shirk? I kind of touched on that. Kufr is more generic and more general. Shirk is a type of kufr. Are you there? Shirk is a type of kufr. But not every kufr is shirk. But every shirk is what? Is kufr. Because shirk is to associate partners with Allah. Huh? But the one who throws the mushaf in the toilet, or he throws it into the bin, or he stands on the mushaf deliberately, he has not done shirk. What has he done? Kufr. He hasn't done. Anyone who, for example, he rejects the Prophet as a prophecy, is he a mushrik? He's a kafir. He's a kafir. So the difference between the two is shirk is it's a type of kufr. Are you with me? It's a type of kufr. What's the difference between nifaq and kufr? Hypocrisy and kufr. The difference between the two is, number one, kufr is more generic. And nifaq is one type of kufr. Are you with me? Kufr is more general. Not every kufr is hypocrisy. Sah? Not every kufr is nifaq. But every nifaq is kufr. But the difference between the underlying difference between the two is the kafir, he shows his kufr. The munafiq, he hides his kufr. So the kufr is there, but he's hiding it. Whereas the kafir, he will show his kufr. Sah? So the munafiq, in the dunya, he's a Muslim. Sah? We deal with him as a Muslim. He's praying with us. So from the dunya, we just deal with him as a Muslim. We don't know him. As for his kufr, the day of judgment, he's in the hellfire. But we don't know his kufr. We spoke about the typing, the first type of kufr. What was the first type of kufr? The first type of kufr, ya ikhwa, is aqsamu al-kufr bi'i'tibari hukmihi. So we're going to categorize the kufr in six types. It's us looking at the kufr from different angles. Just like if we were to look at you and to observe you, we can look at your height if we want to. We can look at you from terms of your weight. We can look at in terms of your complexion. We can look at you in terms of many different ways you can look at a person. We're now going to look at kufr from many different ways. The first type is the type aqsamu bi'i'tibari hukmihi, kufr in terms of its rulings. How many types did we say it is in terms of its rulings? Akbar and Asghar, major and minor. So we already mentioned that. What's kufr akbar? What's the definition of kufr akbar? Kufr akbar is huwa mudadu li asli iman. It's anything that opposes the asl of iman. We already talked about asl of iman, right? Nah. Anything that's in opposition to the foundation of your iman is kufr akbar. You become a kafir. The second one is what? Kufr asghar, minor kufr. This one opposes kamalul iman al-wajib. It opposes what? The wajib of the iman, the kamalul wajib that we spoke about. Are we together, brothers? Kamalul wajib. Anything that goes against kamalul wajib is kufr asghar. And the scholars tend to use the word kufr asghar. Sometimes they use kufr duna kufrin. Sometimes they may even call it kufr ni'mah. All of those are kufr asghar. Now we're going to categorize the kufr into two other different, another type which is called, are you brothers with me? Aqsamul kufr bi'i'tibari bawa'ithi wa asbabihi. The next type, the second type of categorization of kufr is in terms of the root causes for it. So the second one is, what is the root cause for kufr? Al-Imam al-Baghawi rahimahullah says, al-kufru ala arba'ati anha, kufru inkarin, wa kufru juhudin, wa kufru inadin, wa kufru nifaqin. Also Ibn al-Qayyim says, al-kufru al-akbaru khamsatu anwa'in, kufru takdhibin, wa kufru istikbarin, wa ima'in, ma'at tasdiqi, wa kufru i'radin, wa kufru shakkin, wa kufru nifaqin. Hafidh al-Hakami rahimahullah says, أن الأنواع الكفر لا تخرج عن أربعة أنواع كفر جهل وتكذيب وجحود وكفر عناد واستكبار وكفر نفاق. The reason I'm not explaining all of that is I want to bring them all together now. I quickly mentioned the statement of who? الإمام البغوي ابن القيم حافظ الحكمي رحمه الله. The kufr all goes back to six. When you get all of the statements of the scholars, the root causes for those kufr is six. Okay, it's six. Are we all together, sisters and brothers? It's six. Write them down and we will explain what each one is. The first one is called Al-Kufru, the Kufr here. So what chapter, what categorization is this? This is the second categorization, right? And it's the causes of where Kufr comes from, where it exits from, where does it come from? Okay? The causes for it, basically. What are the root causes for kufr? Okay, we said it's six, based on whose statement? Baghawi, Hafiz al-Hakami, Ibn al-Qayyim, and others. The first one is called kufrul inkari wa takdhib. The first one is called kufrul inkar wa takdhib. What does kufrul inkar mean? Before I mention each one, can we write them down and then we go over each one? The first one is called kufrul inkari wa takdhib. Kufru, al-inkar, wa al-takdhib. The second one is called kufru al-juhud. Al-juhud. Kufru al-juhud. The third one is called kufru al-inad wa al-istikbar. Kufru al-inad wa al-istikbar. The fourth one is called kufru al-nifaq. Kufru al-nifaq. The fifth one is called Kufr al-I'rad. Kufr al-I'rad. And the sixth one is called Kufr al-Shak. Kufr al-Shak. If you missed any of those six, don't worry, we'll go through each one. Let's go back to the first one. The first one we said is called what? Kufr al-Inkar. Kufr al-Inkar wa al-Takdhib. What does inkar mean? Inkar means, as Imam al-Baghawi mentioned in his tafsir, أَلَّا يَعْرِفَ اللَّهَ أَصْلًا, that the person does not know Allah at all. And he does not recognize him. And he does not acknowledge him. This is what it means.